Hello friends, I'm Shweta here again with a new video today. In this video, I'm going to show you all a very simple design in liquid embroidery for the kurti neck. Okay, it's just running stitch design which I'm going to show you. Okay, for this, what we have to do is we have to take the top cloth and fold it into exact half in the center and take a measuring tape and mark 3 inches or 3.5, how whatever the neck width you want. Usually this is the measurement that we keep, 3 or 3.5. Here I'm keeping 3.5 inch. Okay, and the deep will be 7, but I'm keeping it here 8, so that 1 extra inch I'm keeping for the stitching. So it's 8 inches and here it is 3.5 inches. Okay, so let's just make the shape of the neck. If you are not comfortable making the marking and all, what you can do is you can go to the tailor and you can get the marking done from them. They will do it and give it. Or if you know tailoring, it is really good, then you can mark it on your own. Okay, in the same way, we should make it on the other side also. Or what you can do is, you can just fold it reverse and just press it so that it will mark it on its own. Okay, so I think I just marked a little extra. That's okay, it's a rough sketch. Okay, anyways, the tailor is going to mark on their own and again they are going to cut it. Okay, so this is just for the sample. And what you have to do is you just measure your kurta and see the chest level. So I'm going to keep for 36, so that is 18 inch I'm keeping. Okay, so 9 inch on the left side and 9 inch on the right side is what I'm going to mark it. So this will be our working area, and if you just want below neck level, then you have to just mark 1.5 inch below the neck. So here I'm marking 1.5 inch and make a square shape marking. Okay, I'm using the normal chalk. You can use marking chalk. Okay, so this is the area which we are going to work on now. Okay, if somebody doesn't know the neck lining and all, what they can do is they can just work whatever the chest level is, take 18 inch or 16 inch, however you want, and just make it as a square and in that like a rectangle shape, and then you start working on that. That is fine. The tailor is going to cut the neck part and the work will just go off from there. It's okay, no problem. Okay, and for this I'm taking liquid embroidery pearl metallic copper color. Okay, so again you should have an extra waist cloth always ready with you. And if you're working on cotton cloth, then framing is really not required because sometimes the cloth is very thick, but here I'm using raw silk, so for this we have to frame it. So here is my frame. I have just wrapped the wood tape for the whole ring so that it will not damage our cloth. Okay, and we have to work on part as it is, the smaller ring. Okay, I'm going to take only the half part of it. So I have just framed it. If you are using the tape surrounding the ring, then tightening is not required, because it gives a very good tight finishing to the cloth. Okay, just pull it from all the side and make sure that it is intact. Okay, and here what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make running stitch pattern in horizontal. Okay, so with the help of a small ruler, what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark the distance. I'll keep 1 centimeter gap in between each lines. Okay, and I'm using a glass pencil. So if you're not comfortable drawing straight line freehand, then you can just mark it. So after 4 lines, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make small design here. Okay, so again I'll make 4 more lines. So in this way I'm going to continue the design. So I have marked till this level. So here I'm going to have a long ruler and I'm going to make the length lining a little later. So for this, let's start working now. So before starting the work, we have to clean the tip. Okay, now how we make running stitch in hand embroidery. In the same way, just give little bit of gap in between every stitch and mark it. Don't give too much gap also. Draw slowly so that the finishing will be good. If you want, you can use double color also, or whatever colors you want. And for the beginners, this should be a decent design. So I've done all 4 lines. Now let's do the curve lines. Make sure that you are not working on the connecting lines. So make sure that you're cleaning the nose, like tip of the bottle every now and then, so that the finishing will not spoil. So I've done almost completing the work, whatever I have drawn. So this is how it looks. It exactly looks like hand stitched, okay, when you see from little far, but it gives a very good finishing. For beginners, I think this stitch should be fine, and even the same stitch pattern, you can use it even on sari border or dupattas, anything you wish to. And you can create 4 or 5 lines of this. That itself is more than sufficient. It looks really very nice. So hope you all like the video. If you have any more doubts regarding the pattern, you can always comment me below. And if you like this, please give a thumbs up. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.